I'm Hans Kandel, Extension Agronomist. Today I'm going to talk here about variety selection. One of the things that farmers, of course, are first looking at is the yield. But as far as variety selection in North Dakota, maturity is a very critical thing. Each area has a specific range for maturity, and if we can maximize or want to maximize our yields, that is to select a variety that is appropriate for our growing region and one that has the longest maturity possible. However, at the end of the season, we typically have a frost, so we need to make sure the maturity range is such that it will mature before the frost. We do have a tool on our Endon website which shows us when a maturity is reached. And what we can do is to go to the website, and with the tool we can then put in the maturity of the company, the rating, the location where you are, the closest weather station, and the planting date. And what it will give you is the average maturity prediction for that variety. You can follow this throughout the season. Currently, if we look at our season this year, we have been running about 100 growing degrees more than usually in Carrington. And if we translate it into days, we are about a 6 day earlier. And if we have an 0.5 maturity planted around 18th of May, then we expect it to mature in the first week of September. Currently, we see that some of the earlier maturing varieties are yellowing. They are starting to drop some of their leaves, and the full maturity ratings are still kind of green. So besides the maturity, we also need to consider disease. A couple of the diseases have genetic resistance. One of them is Phytophthora root rot, and most companies will indicate what their genes are that confer the resistance for the particular variety that you select. Another very important matter is to look at white mold. Some varieties are a little bit more tolerant to white mold than others. And the last genetic thing that is very important is cyst nematode. We know that cyst nematode has increased in North Dakota, and especially in the southern part, not as much in the central part yet, but it is very critical that everybody knows if they have a cyst nematode problem in their field. If you have, it is important that you will take a soil sample at the end of the season and determine what the egg levels are in the soil. Once you know what the egg levels are, then you can determine if you need a variety that is tolerant or not. We recommend that if you have cyst nematode, that you use a tolerant variety as well as a longer rotation. So we have been talking here about the main points that you can select for. But of course, one of the main things that you are growing the soybean for is the yield. So every year we do variety trials. We test all the variety trials in replicated trials. And then at the end of the season, we report the data on our variety website. So the easiest way is to go to Variety Trials, NDSU Variety Trials, click on the soybean button, and you will get the most current data that is available. On the eastern part of the state, we have a lot of iron chlorosis. However, also in the central part of the state, iron chlorosis is seen. It typically is on soils with high pH, when it is wet, with high calcareous material in the soil, and we can get a yellowing of the soybeans in the early season. The best way to protect your plants from getting it is to select a variety that is more tolerant than other varieties. So currently, we do have a range of varieties that are significantly different in their tolerance. There is no variety currently that is completely resistant. Each year, we do a test at NDSU where we test all the varieties that are in the variety trials in a location where we know that we have had IDC, and we score all the plots, the varieties, based on the IDC level in that field. That data is currently available, and the best way again is to go to the variety trials, click on the soybean tab, and look for IDC scores. If you have IDC issues in your field, it is very important that you select a variety that has the highest tolerance under your conditions. We have talked about yield, but there are two other factors that are important to consider. One is oil and protein. Currently, producers are not directly paid for oil and protein. However, collectively we are. As we look at the map of the United States, we know that central soybean belt has higher protein and oil than we have here in North Dakota. So there is a little premium discount in North Dakota based on the basis. So in order for us to gain a better value for our crop, it is important to look at oil and protein. It is interesting to know that at the end of the season is the time when a lot of oil is put into the seed. Currently, we have had a very good growing season. We are a little bit ahead of schedule, so it is very likely that we can avoid the frost that potentially does damage. Early frost tends to lower the oil content of the soybeans. So in summary, it is important to look at variety data, and especially looking at data that is generated over more locations, looking at your variety, looking at the disease package, the IDC, and I'm sure that you can select the best variety for your farm.